Jose Mourinho has dealt with everything this season. Former club's reigning champions, Lionel Messi. They've all tried and failed to eliminate FC Inter from the Champions League. He's not previously come up against a former mentor, though. That'll be the task at hand against Louis van Gaal and FC Bayern München in the final.
He's a very confident person. And in a moment where a coach like me was young, that confidence is very important. So in that time in Barcelona, he gave me the confidence to coach the team on the pitch. He gave me sometimes the responsibility to be the coach of the team in friendly matches, in Copa Catalunya matches. He gave me the responsibility to be the coach. He was saying to me, I go to the stands, you take charge of the team. So it was very important in my development. And it's true, when I spoke with him about going to Portugal to be assistant in Benfica, he was saying to me, no, you don't go. You go if he's to be the first coach, not to be the second coach. So tell Benfica, if they want the first coach, you go. If they want a second coach, you stay.
After serving as a translator at FC Barcelona under Bobby Robson, Mourinho stayed on under Van Gaal. The Dutchman clearly had a huge impact on the fledgling career of the young Portuguese. It's surprising then that the two have not spoken for quite some time.
The last time we worked together was in 2000, 99-2000. So we are speaking about 10 years, more than 10 years. So for sure, he's a very different person too. After that, he was national coach in Holland. He spent 3 years, I think, in Alkmaar. Maybe four. So for sure, he's also a different person. But I don't change my mind. He is a great coach, and he's a good person. So I don't think that changed.
Only two coaches have previously won the Champions League with two different clubs, Ernst Happel and Ottmar Hitzfeld. Whatever happens on that Saturday afternoon in Madrid, there will be another name added to the list. If it is Van Gaal and not Mourinho, the Portuguese remains eternally confident he will get there someday.
Sooner or later, I think I will be in that group because I'm a very young coach. I have, I don't know, I hope God gives me conditions for that, but I hope I have 20 more years to coach, so sooner or later I'll be there. I will try to do everything to be there, not really because I want to be in that privileged group in the history of football, but especially because I want to do it with these players, with this club, with these supporters. It would be something different. For Inter, it would be something different than it is for Bayern, for Barcelona, for Man United, for Real Madrid, for teams with a different kind of history. Win the Champions League in the modern time with Inter would be something great. So I'm more focused on that than focused on I'm the third or I'm not the third to do it. I will do it one day, but I would love it to do it now because of the circumstances of Inter is not winning the competition for a long time.
Having already eliminated his former club Chelsea, you'd be forgiven for thinking that the chances of a familiar face ruining Mourinho's year were over, but not so. FC Bayern München's outstanding individual is a player that needs no introduction to the FC Inter coach.
Yeah, I know Robin very well, of course. He was my player for three years. A top player. Messi is Messi, but Arjen is for sure, when he's physically well, and this season he had a great season in terms of injuries because he had a very bad season in Madrid. The last season in Chelsea was the same. He was hit by many injuries, but when Arjen is able to play 4, 5, 6 consecutive months, he's an incredible player. I remember his season in England when he came the first 2004-2005. I think he scored goals in 8 consecutive matches. An incredible player. So he's a player we have to be worried with, but I don't change I don't change the way of think football, and especially because like Messi is, like Ronaldo is, he's a player of movement. He's not a player that you can say he plays always in the same area. He plays always against the same opponent. So our defense is zonal pressing. We don't change, and the position where Arjen is, of course, he needs a double attention because he's a super player.
Mourinho has already stifled another superb player this season when he masterminded, and not for the first time, a way to stop Lionel Messi. FC Inter have already enjoyed domestic success this season, but the Champions League would of course be their crowning glory. Mourinho explains the team's ethos.
No, it's just the concept of the group is more important than all of us. We must do everything we can to help the group. Is the player that is injured and try to recover to give his contribution. Is the player that is on the bench and comes to play 5 minutes, and in these 5 minutes he wants to help the team. Is the player that is on the pitch and needs to help the player in a difficult situation. And you gave the example of Etu as a great example. Of course, he is a player with a big status. Of course, he is an attacking player. When the team were living a difficult moment and need him to do an extra work for the team, he was the first one to do it. And when you have in the group this kind of players with big status and they are able to do this, it's easy to be a leader, because after that the other people must follow this kind of example.
Mourinho has been linked with a permanent stint at Santiago Bernabeu next season, but it's only one game at the stadium that holds his current concentration. You can see it live right here on UEFA.com. FC Inter tackle FC Bayern München on Saturday, May the 22nd, in the Champions League final.